We have to ask the question, why? When is the right time to call for a mark?
Spýtal by sa, či nepotrebujú tam niečo toho, čo musím. A to, čo sa Herbie mala ako dári a príde k tomu, aby nám ukázal nejaké ulievky, je, že si povieme, kedy je správny čas ulievky.
Typically, if you want to get a runner, a good runner into scoring position from first base to second base or second base to third base, that's the good time.
Vo všeobecnosti je dobrým časom na to, aby si ulievali, keď chcete dostať dobrého bežca z prvej mety na druhú, alebo z druhej mety na tretiu, proste posúdiť do skorovacej pozície.
Now, oftentimes I will hit Dario first or second in the lineup because he's a good bunt man, he's also a good hit run man.
Veľmi rád dávam Daria ako prvého druhého na pálku, pretože je to dobrý ulievkár a takisto je to dobrý pálkár, ktorému môžem gaučovať i ten rán.
He knows that one of his jobs to do as a hitter is to sometimes be able to advance runners from first to second or second to third.
On ako dobrý pálkár vie, že často býva jeho úlohou posunúť bežca, obetovať sa za to, aby posunul nášho bežca bližšie.
And that's why they call it a sacrifice bunt, because he is sacrificing his time at bat to help his teammates out.
A to je presne to, čomu hovoríme, seba obetovacia ulievka, pretože on sa obetuje sám seba na to, aby posunul niekoho z našich hráčov bližšie k úlohe.
Okay, so here's the situation. I'm coaching third, I'm giving the signs and everything, and Dario's in the box, he checks down at me, he sees the sign.
A je to situácia, ja som v boxe, dávam nejaké signály, Dario je tam, pozerá sa na mňa a tie signály prijíma.
I don't expect him to acknowledge or give it back to me. He knows the sign is on. I know he knows the sign is on. Now,
mi dáva nejaké signály späť, že vie, čo hrá. Proste ja viem, že on vie, čo mu dávam a to je podstatné.
Basically what we teach again is a pivot bunt. It's strictly a pivot bunt. Now I come set.
To, čo robí normálne, tá vytočená úlievka, to, čo nastáva, ako nahliadne do setu.
When is the best time for the hitter to pivot and show the bunt?
Kedy je najlepší čas pre pálkara otočiť sa a ukázať tú ulievku? Pri sebaobetovacej ulievke je to pravdepodobne v momente, ako náhle ten nahádzovač rozpojí ruky. Takže videli ste, ako to funguje, to čo chceme.
One thing I would do with Dario is start the bat a little bit higher, start at the top of the strike zone.
Yeah, aby začal s tou úlievkou trošku vyššie, na vrchole strike zóny.
As you can see, Dario did not pick his feet up. All he did was pivot and open his body up to the pitcher.
A ak si všimli, vôbec nedvíhal nohy. Jedine, čo spravil na tom mieste, ako tie nohy mal sa vytočiť. No, to bolo celé.
And what I teach is an angle bunting, and I think most coaches teach angle bunting.
A to, čo ja učím, je ulievať s tou pálkou pod uhlom. A väčšina kaučov takýmto istým spôsobom učí nie.
Don't see very many people teaching a flat bunt anymore.
Neuvidíte už dnes veľa ľudí, ktorí učia ulievať s tou pálkou rovno.
Now, I've seen some people go this high. I don't like that.
A videl som niektorých ľudí, ktorí to ulievajú takto vysoko. Dnes to nepáči.
Now, the reason why we start the bat at the top of the strike zone is when Dario has to go down to get a pitch down here, he simply just lowers his knees to get it.
To, prečo to robíme takto, je, že keď Dario dostane nižší nadhod, tak veľmi jednoducho len pokrčí kolena a tú ulievku nastaví do pálku tam, kde tá loptička letí.
Now from there he's in a good position about the ball.
A teraz je teda v dobrej pozícii na to, aby tú loptu ulieval.
Where do we put a sacrifice ball? Where's the good place?
A kam budeme umiestňovať obetovaciu ulievku? Kde je to dobré miesto?
If you are bunting the man from first base to second base,
ak posúvate bežca z prvej mety,
it's not that important, but it's important to get it closer to a baseline, first baseline.
Nie, nie je to tak dôležité. Dôležité je, aby sme tú ulievku umiestnili niekde do blízkosti postranníča, či už tretmenného prvomenu.
Now, when the ball is coming in to him, when the ball is coming in to Dario, one thing he's not going to do, when his hands are almost extended, go ahead, Dario.
Ja mám na okolade k nemu, čo on nebude robiť. Jeho ruky sú teraz takmer vystreté.
And he is simply going to think about catching the ball on the bat.
A jediné, čo on uvažuje teraz, niečo chytanie loptičky na bat.
Some of us say kissing the ball. Just kiss the ball.
A boskávanie loptičky, len poboskať.
Now, the one thing you don't want to do as a bunter, guys, is this.
To, čo nechceme robiť na olievku, je toto.
Push. Push it. You don't want to push. Why? For what reason?
Nechceme to spraviť, ale prečo? Kvôli jednému dôvodu. Poduviny.
Softies.
They are incredible. Aby to vôbec bolo, aby to bolo.
Now, the base hit, I mean the foul ball is not going to hurt you. It's a foul ball.
Foul ball vám neublíží. Foul ball je foul.
But it doesn't do you any good to butt back here to the pitcher because
you will not be successful. Ale nemá žádný smysl to bude prémo protože neuspějete. Prostě budete vyautovat.
Can anybody see if there's any...
Tretí metár je, povedzme si, ďaleko, hlboko v poli hra.
Third baseman is heavy, overweight, slow.
A tretí metár je veľmi ťažký, pomalý.
And Dario, the element of surprise.
Alebo Dario ako je pod prekvapenie.
You guys were not in Germany 2 years ago when we beat Sweden in the last inning.
Vy chlapci neboli zrejme doma roky v Nemecku, keď sme porazili v poslednom inningu Švedy.
We had the bases loaded with two outs.
Mali sme mety obsadené s dvomi autami.
And we were not, I had my number 9 hitter up and he's over there working with the catchers. He was not swinging very well.
A mali sme tam 9. Pálkara, ktorý bohuje ako nepál.
So I made a decision at that time. It was a gamble. It was a big gamble, but I just made a decision.
Vtedy som urobil rozhodnutie, bol to obrovský risk. Strávil som to rozhodnutie.
To give Mickey the bunt. Two outs, the bases loaded.
A dal som Mickey Kukulievar na situáciu 2 outy a mety obsadené.
Thank goodness we were successful because it was a gamble. A big gamble on my
part.
And we won the game and the people in the stands said, oh my goodness, you know, that's great, that's great. It was one of those deals. If we were successful, it was great for me. If we weren't, then I would be a loser.
Vyšlo to, chvala Pánu Bohu, vyhrali sme ten zápas. Ľudia boli úplne blázni na druhý, kričali, yes, perfect, fantastic. Boli absolútne šťastní a mal som šťastie, že to vyšlo, hej, pretože ja som bol ten, kto tak rozhodol. Keby to nevyšlo, ja som ten somár, ktorý tak proste nevyšlo.
Dario, let's do the fake bunt.
Dario, poď, spravíme tú naznačenú.
We did this a lot in Italy 4 years ago, where we would fake the bunt. Okay, here we go, show it. But not slash, the fake bunt, no slash. Pitcher comes set, he's going to show it. And he's going to take a pitch, or he's going to fake a drag
bunt. Alebo, lebo ju naznačí, nerobí sledge, hej? Iba naznačí a stiahne späť, alebo naznačí ju ako útočnú úliu.
Now, why would a team want to do a fake bunt?
A prečo by tým mal chcieť robiť takúto
úliu? What is the third base and first base going to do when they see it?
Čo spraví tretí metár, keď to uvidí?
Now as a third baseman, I start creeping in a little bit. What that does is it creates more holes in the infield for Dario to get a base hit.
Takže v momente, keď ten tretí meter vyštartuje dopredu na to, aby Dario mu lepšie spracovával, vytvorí väčší priestor, to je infieldne na to, aby Dario bol úspešný pri tom hite.
So, now that opens up another situation, another possibility for a different type of problem.
A toto nám otvára priestor pre ďalšiu situáciu, pre ďalší druh ulievu.
Guys, heads up here.
Pozerať, dávajte pozor, lebo sa bude páliť. No, to
je
to rýchlo bol, takže pohod. Ide to
zbogu. I give Dario the fake bunt slash sign. He sees that the infield is moving in. I give him the sign. What I want him to do then is show the bunt early.
Hej, to čo chceme, aby ukázal to jednu druhú skôr. Hej, aby tá rýchla si ho stiahnuť.
And he's selling it. He wants the infielders to think that he is going to bunt. But he's going to draw back and then try and slap the ball through the infield.
Show it.
Obviously, he's not swinging hard, so, but he would in the game. Show it. Go ahead and swing it, Arnold. Show it early, sell it. Okay, and that's exactly what we want to do, is try and get it through the infield. Show it, sell it. Okay, let's go left side, Dario. Second baseman squeezing, show it. Left side, give him. Right side, left side. All right. That is called a fake bunt and slash.
To voláme klamaná úlievka, natančená úlievka a slash.
Okay, you have a runner on first. first base now.
Máte base na prvé mene.
Coaches.
Gauči.
Is the steel sign and the drag button.
Je to signál, ktorý signalizuje meštere krádež a zároveň válka
Okay, now, what I will do is, I will give the steel sign to the runner on first, and I will give the sacrifice punt to Dario. And Dario, what baseline do we want to put it down?
Ak by som dal krátnutomu bežcovi na prvé mete a Dariovi ulieť ulievku ako sebaobetovaciu, ktorú čiaru na ktorú stranu by ulieval?
So running back now. Who do we want to field the ball?
Teraz to run and bunt. Kto by mal spracovať?
Tell him, bro.
Kto chceme, aby spracovával tú vec?
Third baseman. Why?
Third baseman,
yes.
Treťom metu.
Okay, steal is on. There he goes. Now, they bunt the gate. Here's the point. First, the runner on first stealing second.
Pretože ak bežec z prvej kradne tú druhú metu.
Now, many times teams that are not well coached or pitchers that are not very smart,
tímy, ktoré nie sú veľmi dobre kaučované, nahadzovači, ktorí nie sú príliš múdri,
they will come over here and make the play, but the third baseman is also making the play too, so who is covering third, Casey?
Idú hrať nahadzovači, ktorí vôbec kovali 3. metu, ktorí nie
hrať kovali, kto bude kryť tú 3. metu? Nobody's covering third!
Nikto nekryje to. Toho bežca z prvej mety až na
druhé. You runners on first base, when you're stealing in that situation, you have to be thinking.
Ak ste bežci na prvej mety, v tejto situácii
máš úplne mysleť a na to, čo to bude stať. About getting all the way to third base. Dario, you have to be thinking about if you possibly can get to third base.
A Dario, ty ako pátra, musí mysleť na to, že chceš, ak je to možné, uliať po čiare.
Okay. Kiwi, would you be a runner on third base, please? You're a base runner now.
Kiwi, teraz, bežec na tretej mete.
Okay, let's talk about the suicide squeeze. Go back.
Poďme teraz Mario, no, som teraz tam squeeze.
And we will work on this a lot. Not because he's a very fast runner, but I will work on this with players with average speed also.
Práve to s tým veľmi často, a nie preto, že je to nejaký
Now, this is a base running drill, but I want to talk about this now because it's important because we will work on this in practice a lot.
Je to drill, čo týka skôr base runningu, ale budeme o tom hovoriť teraz, pretože je to dosť dôležité. Teraz sa to spraví.
Now, whether I am in the stretch here or the wind up, there's a specific time when Kiwi wants to break home.
Je to, či som v sete alebo v wind up, je istý špecifický time,
Now, when I come set and I lift, he's not going to break right away.
Hey, ja som sete, dvíham nohu, ale on stále ešte nerozbíhal.
You understand the problem if he were to leave room?
Musíte rozumieť, ten problém, ktorý nastáva,
keby to bol strach. Just leave room, break
the room. Vybehni skôr.
Okay, now, what I would do...
Čo som robil?
In that situation, if I see that runner break early, I'm not going to throw it that high, but I'm going to throw it about this high, head high.
Čo spraví, keď to také zostane? Nehodím, ako si postavil teraz, ale hodím, ako si na úroveň jeho hlad, hodišnýho hlad.
It's very difficult to run a ball.
Je veľmi ťažké to hlad to uliať.
That's up here.
Ako vysoko.
It's very difficult to run a ball down on the ground.
A je to šialené ťažké uliať, čo si späť na zem.
Chances are it's going to go up.
A je veľmi šance, že tam bude hore.
What I want Kiwi to really break is, when I come here, he's just going to be doing his secondary leads.
To, čo má Kiwi robiť, keď ja začnem nahazovať, je, že keď zbíham to na úplne, ktoré klasické, či sekundárny výbek.
He will not break until the pitcher is ready to release the ball.
A nevyštartuje skôr, ako v tom momente, keď ten nahazovač je pripravený.
Time where I think we have to have an acknowledgement from the the coach, just to know. I'm going to tell him a lot of times, I'll just say, I'll whisper in his ears.
Toto je čas, kedy treba, aby tie informácie videli s pápárom všetci. Teraz som jemu šepkal druhý na to, druhý na to.
Zagreb and Karlovac in the finals this year.
Zagreb and Karlovac in the finale this year.
Krunov is here.
Krunov is here.
And the bases loaded and nobody out.
Mety obsadené a bez auta.
And you know his younger brother Danny.
Poznáte jeho mladšieho brata.
One of my players.
Jeden z hráčov.
He gave his own brother the bunt sign with the bases loaded and nobody out.
A on dal svojom bratovi na takúto situáciu.
Okay, so you have to know when a good time for the bunt is, when to put it on.
Musíte aj takisto vedieť teda, kedy je ten správny čas, aby sa bojil, kedy nie.
Okay, I've got a couple of minutes left here.
Máme tu pár minút navyše.
Let's see, we'll talk a little bit about tips. A couple of things to remember. It's okay to bunt, and we did this in 1998 in Štakarov, when we were playing Georgia.
Povieme si nejaké takéto zážitky. Mali sme pred dvoma rokmi v Štokerau sme hrali proti Gruzii.
I can't remember if Slovakia was there. Was 98 in
Štokerau? Yes, boss. Slovakia was there. Nebudeme dať, či Slovensko tam bolo. Slovensko tam bolo.
How many of you saw the game? Do you remember the game?
Koľko z vás ste videli ten zápas? Pamätáte si ten zápas?
We were playing Georgia, and Georgia had a very good pitcher.
Hrali sme proti Gruzínsku a Gruzínsko malo veľmi dobrý hráč.
And it was like 0-0 or 1-1.
A bolo to asi 0-0 alebo 1-1.
And it was late in the game, in the 7th inning, and I finally said...
A bolo to neskoro v zápase, asi v 7. inningu, a ja som povedal...
We are not hitting this guy, I have to go to the bunting game.
Povedal som si, my tohto chlapca asi nerozpálime, poďme ho umrieť, mali by sme asi zumrieť.
We bunted 3 different hitters in a row. 3 times in a row we did it.
Trikrát po sebe sme ulievali rôzne typy ulievky, rôznymi palkami a trikrát po sebe to vyšlo.
The Georgia team was so frustrated.
Gruzínsko bolo tak frustrované, tak nahnevané.
Their pitcher lost his focus. We went on to score 7 runs, I think.
Nahadzovač sa tak rozpilil a rozčúlil, že strátil sústredenosť a skorovali sa v tom inningu 7 bodov.
We scored all of our runs that inning, we beat them 7-1, and that was the game that put us in the 8th pool for the next year in Italy.
A skorovali sme v tom inningu 7 bodov, zápas skončil 7-1, a to bol ten zápas, ktorý rozhodol o tom, že my sme išli do ďalší rok do Talianska, do A-skupiny.
So coaches, my point is, if you have the opportunity, put the pressure on them. Put the pressure on the defense.
Takže coachi, chcem vám povedať, že ak máte tú možnosť, zatlačte na nich. Zatlačte na tú obranu.
Okay. One more thing I can do, and I do this in my, another one of the drills I didn't talk about, and I do it with my kids, with little guys, but it depends on how much money you have.
A toto je drill, ktorý, o ktorom som nehovoril, a ktorý niekedy s tými malými kopcami robí. Ale závisí to od toho, ako veľa peniazí má.
But if you have
baseball cards,
or if you have money,
$100.
One thing I found in my baseball camps when I work with the kids on bunting, we do this all over in Croatia with the kids, I'll put money or baseball cards, usually it's baseball cards, but they have to try and hit the cards or the money with their butts. So it makes them focus.
Takže to, čo spravím, že rozsvietim na kartičky alebo peniaze po ihrisku, A decka sa snažia tu ten peniaz a tú bankovku alebo kartičku trafiť u nieho. Kto ho ju trafi, tak ten to bere. Kto si to chce vyskúšať?
Sú jedno dole. No?
Je tak, máte za tú situáciu, že máte prvom metára príliš hlboko.
The second baseman deep also.
A druhom metára takisto hlboko.
I don't use this a lot with my team, but it is a very good bunt if
the punter is confident in his abilities.
Ja to veľmi nepoužívam toto, ale je to dobrá ulievka, pokiaľ ten pálka je si vedomý svojich schopností, ten ulievač.
Excellent bunt.
Vynikajúca ulievka.
Can you do it three times in a row?
Ešte raz, to dokážu práve týkať
posledný. All right, he's a great bottle, let's give him a hand.
To je plechovica naplnená pieskom, od ktorých svojich vod. Cvičenie na zariate a posilovanie.
Tennis ball too, filled with sand, taped together.
Brázne obal, ktorý sa do lopty, tam boli tenisky, naplnený pieskom, zalevený.
Very expensive tool.
Veľmi drahý.
Okay. You can also use canned vegetables.
Môžete zavaranené ovocie.
This looks a little bit more impressive than a can of corn in your bag.
Vyzerá to také trošku je to väčšie dojem, ako keď máte v ruce.
On your list here, we're going to go through several of these exercises, and you're all going to get, well, most of you are going to get a chance to try some of these. In each one of these types of exercises, some of them are very similar because you're trying to do the same types of things. What you're doing just in a little different way. To start off, it's important, a lot of people know about the surgical tubing, you've all maybe had a chance to work with some of it. Most of the time it's done because you've injured yourself and you're trying to rehab.
Častokrát sa práve tieto veci používajú až potom, keď ste boli zranení počas rehabilitácie.
In the last several years,
počas posledných pár rokov,
coaches have come to the conclusion, why wait till you're hurt to strengthen those muscles? Why not do it ahead of time?
Coachy prišli k logickému záveru, prečo používať tieto nástroje až potom, keď sa zraníte, prečo nepomôže ešte predtým, ako na posilovanie.
Generally, when you injure yourself throwing, it is not one of the major muscles like the deltoid.
Všeobecne, keď si zraníte ruku pri hádzaní, niekto jeden z tých veľkých svalov, ramenný sval alebo triceps.
Bicep.
Alebo biceps.
You don't injure those.
Tie sa väčšinou
It's the nebraní. Small muscles, connecting muscles underneath.
Ale sú tie malé spájajúce masle, svaly pod týmito svalami.
Two things happen. The throwing action is a very powerful, explosive action.
Dve veci sa stávajú. V prvom rade je to, že pohyb taký je náročný, explosívny pohyb.
And if those muscles have been dormant or they haven't worked very much in the last several months,
ak tieto svaly spali počas dlhšie doby, alebo neboli používané počas dlhšie obdobia,
the little muscles get injured and you have to strengthen them.
Čiže tie malé svaly sa môžu zraniť a treba ich posilovať.
Also, when your arm is decelerating,
a ruka keď vlastne spomaluje,
you're trying to gain great velocity from here to there,
snažíte sa získať vysokú energiu, rýchlosť odtiaľto po sem.
And then your arm has to slow down to get to here.
A potom vaša ruka musí spomaliť na to, aby sa dostala sem.
As a result, we can injure those smaller muscles back in this area, slowing down.
Následkom práve pri tom spomalovaní môže byť zranenie týchto svalov vzadu.
What we want to do is to strengthen those muscles so that they have less chance of being injured.
Takže našim cieľom je posilniť tieto malé svaly tak, aby bola nižšia šanca na zranenie.
So we're going to go through a few exercises as with these different things we have here. Also, see a glove. You can use a glove. Put a baseball or two in the glove. And you can use it for exercises, doing various things, because it weighs a little bit more and it gives you some resistance. You don't have to have real exotic tools. You can go through this. Okay, first of all, we need to warm up the muscles a little bit. So let's spread out just a little bit. I'm going to have to stick your arms out.
Put it.
Wait, stick your arms out. Those of you that have gloves, put the glove in your hand. Okay, you're going to do about 10 small circles. 10 small circles, and then make them a little bit bigger. Okay, you should start feeling your arms are getting a little bit tired. Now do the same thing going backward, the other direction. 10 small circles. Okay, I want you to put two baseballs in one hand and your glove in the other hand. Doing these exercises.
Good.
Bigger. Okay, you're warming up those muscles. Using a sand can, you can do similar things. Okay, also leaning forward. All you're doing is just rotating and relaxing the muscles. Okay, get them bigger and bigger. And do it the other direction. You're stretching the muscles, but they're relaxing. Okay, what I would like to do is get some volunteers with some of these cords. We need some volunteers. Grab that one. Somebody else grab this rubber band.
Teraz začneme robiť tzv. 10 hviezd.
Okay, I'm going to stand here. I'm going to bring my hand up in front. And bring it right back down here. Out to a 45. Bring it down. Out to the side. Back to a 45. Straight back. And then just repeat coming back. Okay, just do that one time. Palm up. There we go. You control the resistance by how short that is. So you do your palm up and go all the way through. You're going to 45 degree angle. Baseball is in your hand.
Baseball.
You're going to do this, go ahead and stick your arm out to the side. Right here like this. Okay, what he's going to do, 6 to 8 times, he's going to drop this down right to here, and then bring it right back up. You want to make sure your elbow stays in the same place. If you have to, use your free hand. You're going 90 degrees.
You know what is a good thing? This slider.
Now, you can utilize a fence or have a partner hold the punching bar. What we want to try to do is you're going to keep your elbow into your ribs. Get enough tension, so you're
going
to have to work a little bit. And we're just going to bring it right here to the front, to the opposite side. 6 to 8 times. Okay, then you're going to start out here, get a little farther out. Elbow straight out to the side, hands up to the side. And you're going to come just to the 90. Try to keep that elbow right against your ribs. Okay, this is called an internal abductor. Now you turn around. Turn around this way. And I'm going to go from here out to the 90. This way. Across. Now I'm going a little bit more in this direction. And I'm going to go all the way up. The work I'm bringing up here. I'm just going to bring this up here. 6 to 8 times. Keep the elbow down by your hip. Okay, so you're getting that same resistance, a little bit of weight that you would have with the bungee cord. What you do is bring this arm all the way across, bring the baseball or your hand all the way across to the opposite shoulder. Okay, arm doesn't have to be completely straight. So 6 to 8 times. What you're doing is you're working on those muscles contracting, coming across. Then you can go from here and just work on extensions. These are great. Step out. These are called J chords. You're working on that extension of your throat. Extension of the throat.
Thank you.
slide down as you extend. You're extending through and hitting the ball this way. Just working on the art extension. Notice that my palm is up, palm is down. Then it will slide down here. And they work just like the surgical tubing. Same type of thing. When you want to do exercises here, you can go out to the side. You can have a partner hold it back here. Okay, now, what you want to do,
six on the other side.
Okay.
Plank catch.
Uh-huh.
They start here with the ball in their glove. They step, turn, throw. They try to hit the head. Ready?
Yeah.
Try to hit the head. Go.
Good. Now, they're older players. They might be more old.
When I catch a ball, somebody throws me a ball, I catch it. I've got to have my knees bent. I can't be catching a ball like this.
Go.
That's okay, that's okay. Even though he missed the head, was the ball low? The idea behind the drill is so they don't rotate and throw the ball back here. Good. Again? Ready? Go. Now, if the ball goes right or left, if it goes left, it's because they did what? Or that? Now we know that playing catch is fun for about 5 minutes, and after a while your mind starts to forget things. This is kind of fun, because they're trying to hit an object. but they're also, it forces you to release the ball out front. Okay, a couple more times.